So I've got a bone to pick with this subtitle, because it was not lost on me that Survivor did Game Changers first. But, you know, give credit where it's due, I think this show did the Game Changers motto much, much more justice. A lot more fun to watch than Survivor Game Changers actually was. I mean, Jesus. Welcome back to the channel, and welcome back to another installment of TV Thoughts. As per, I thank you all so much for stopping by, and I hope you enjoy your stay. Because this time around, we're hopping onto Disney Plus to check out the Mighty Ducks Game Changers. Yeah, I finally got a chance to sit through this whole series. It's based off of the classic sports film from the 90s starring Emilio Estevez. And this series once again stars Estevez as Coach Gordon Bombay, along with an extremely fun cast of all new characters. And the Mighty Ducks Junior Hockey team is now a powerhouse in its division, and it's very selective about who makes the cut. And after being kicked off the team, a 12-year-old boy named Evan, at the urging of his mother, forms a brand new hockey team of underdogs known as the Don't Bothers. Yes, they're really called the Don't Bothers. They do this all with the help of the Ducks' original coach, Gordon Bombay, once again played by Emilio Estevez, as I've alluded to. So those of you who've been with the channel for a while, you already know this, but one of my biggest guilty pleasures in terms of genre is the underdog sports movie. And just to recap for you, a little history lesson, if you will. Bad News Bears was the movie that did the underdog little team that could kind of story first. I reviewed that movie a couple of months ago, and long story short, it's an instant classic. I still love it. But then during the 90s, we got this really strange kick of all these sports movies being released one after the other. Little Giants was one of those movies released in that big surge. That's another movie I reviewed a while back. And I love Little Giants. It's a childhood favorite of mine. But the one movie that started this big surge in the 90s and starting that downward spiral in quality, yep, you guessed it, The Mighty Ducks. Even though I do find the movie very fun, a lot of people found themselves extremely inspired by it. My high school drama teacher is actually one of those people. I know that's one of his personal favorites. But in my opinion, the original Mighty Ducks film is clearly extremely formulaic. It literally follows that Bad News Bears blueprint beat by beat as far as I see it. And to answer your question, no. I really don't have any desire to check out any of those sequels. But from what I hear, they're all pretty much scrub, rinse, repeat. As I've mentioned though, there's a lot of folks who still love that original film. I'm kind of indifferent towards it, but there's a lot of people who've been telling me I should check this series out. And as I'm always looking for suggestions here on the channel, lo and behold, I decided to take the leap. And for what it was, I actually really found myself enjoying Game Changers. One thing I particularly enjoyed were the performances of all the children in this. They are throwing their freaking all into this series. And I love how all the Don't Bothers themselves aren't the usual nerdy stereotypes or the heavyset food-loving stereotypes or even the badass female stereotypes. Those are all turned completely upside down here to fit with the more modern take. God damn, there was a lot of TikTok discussion in this. There's this kid named Nick, who's a really fun character, a podcaster turned best friend of Evan the All-Star. There's a kid named Kubler, who is obsessed with video games, and his basement, who they recruit to be the goalie. And might I add, he also has the voice of an angel. And the females of the Don't Bothers are also tons of fun. There's a little girl named Lauren, obsessed with cosplaying, which is super neat. And the All-Star female named Sophie, who defects from the Mighty Ducks herself, is being groomed for a spot at an Ivy League. That's a really fun arc in and of itself. Speaking of, Evan himself, the main kid played by Brady Noon, he's got a lot of really fun little arcs throughout the entire season. There's one episode where he scores a hat trick, which for those of you hockey fans will know what that is. That's 3 goals in one game. And then the very next episode, this really over-the-top coach who's manning the Mighty Ducks right now, yeah, he's trying to recruit Evan to join the Ducks again. And that causes a lot of inner turmoil, as you would expect. But those are just a couple of examples. The kids are honestly so much fun to watch. Their camaraderie, undisputed. Lauren Graham plays Alex, Evan's mother who starts the team. She does a fairly good job, although I will say she does have a few moments where the writers kind of give her some dialogue that is so over the top annoying. Not her fault though. There's one episode, I'm not even joking you, it feels like a legit copy and paste of Kicking and Screaming. Yeah, remember this movie? Will Ferrell and Robert Duvall playing rivaling Pee-wee soccer coaches? Oh, good times. But she's still fairly good in the series. I'm not saying she's a bad performer by any means. I just think that it should have been focused solely on the kids. Now, speaking of great performances and great moments, The standout for me, it's really no contest here, Emilio Estevez's Gordon Bombay. He was awesome in this. I loved him once again. The way he approaches this arc, Estevez clearly understands every single beat. And it was so cool to see him back playing one of his most iconic roles, not named Andrew Clark. As well as in general, I haven't really seen the guy do anything new in years. It was just really awesome to see him. But all these great performances isn't to say that the show is devoid of any negatives. Of course not. First of all, I will warn you, the show does tend to fall back into that nostalgic, formulaic trap of the 90s. Not to say that this series completely lacks any and all surprises. That episode where the original team reunites with Bombay? Awesome! And the finale didn't pan out exactly as I had expected either. I actually thought it was a fantastic finale. But I should also warn you guys, it does take a while to get into Game Changers. Once it gets to around the midpoint of the season, maybe even the last third of it, I thought it was really, really awesome around that point, but it is kind of slow towards the beginning, especially the premiere, which I thought, unfortunately, was extremely weak. And that's mainly because this is kind of a mild spoiler. It was just made way too damn easy for the Don't Bothers to actually join the league. And we actually do see that process pan out where Evan and his pal Nick the Podcaster, they actually go out and recruit other outsiders like a Kubler, like a Lauren, all to join in on the fun. Now this can lead to some fun montages, but think about this for a second. Think about how the Bad News Bears became a team. Remember how one of the kids' fathers who was an attorney actually sued the Little League for not including his son or any of these kids? Yeah, that doesn't happen here. Evan's mom does not threaten to sue the Mighty Ducks whatsoever. And I'm guessing that was to make her a more likable character than Bob Whitewood from Bad News Bears. But at least the way the Bears became a team was actually believable. There's no paperwork that Alex has to sign. There's no ropes she really had to jump through. No obstacles whatsoever. The Don't Bothers just to join the league. Another thing, and this is coming from a guy who didn't watch any of the sequels. How on earth did Bombay become a recluse at the Ice Palace? What was that antecedent beat there? The show Showrunners try to explain it, but again, it just doesn't really add up to me, sadly. In a sense, to me, it kind of felt forced, guys. And yeah, this forced part is gonna make me lead into something that I know is gonna make a lot of people mad. But I don't care, I'm just gonna say it. I cannot help but notice the Cobra Kai comparisons with Game Changers. You know, the new kids wanting to learn the sport, the old guns showing them the ropes, the big championship climax. Yeah, I know this. And to answer the million-dollar question that's on everybody's mind at this point, of course Cobra Kai does it better. And it's a lot more fun to watch. Every single time Cobra Kai ends a season, I'm always begging the showrunners for what's next. Now, I don't want to spoil anything further for y'all, but the way the Game Changers series concludes, I don't really need to see anymore. I think I got exactly what I wanted. Now, I realize a lot of the reason why this finish appeared may be because they're still kind of testing the waters to see if people even have an interest in a second season. I personally don't have any desire for one, guys. And I can't help but think that this show only exists to be Disney's answer, or better yet, equivalence to Cobra Kai. Nevertheless, I'm gonna give the Mighty Ducks Game Changers a C+. I enjoyed this show. I think the hardcore Mighty Duck fans are gonna find some really awesome nostalgic moments with it, along with some fun performances across the board, especially from the children and from the returning Emilio Estevez. This is all just one guy's opinion, though. What do you guys think of Game Changers? Did you like it? Did you hate it? Do you guys have a desire for a second season? And I'm also curious, what is your guys' favorite nostalgic 90s sports film? And if you guys also want to let me know which NHL team you're repping, let me know down in the comments section. Go Sharks! But as you guys know, I love making these videos and discussing cinema and all things entertainment with you guys. If this sounds like content you're interested in, please consider hitting that subscribe button down below as hard as you possibly can. It's totally free and you can always change your mind later, folks. And be sure to hit that thumbs up button on your way out too. That's also extremely helpful to get this content out there. As always, guys, look out for more exciting content hitting this channel very, very soon. You guys are the best. And with all that being said, back talk commence.